Right now is Dr. Sol DeJesus, Chief of the Division of Movement Disorders at Penn State Health, and Dr. Jim McInerney, neurosurgeon at Penn State Health. Thank you both for being with us. What an incredible story, Dr. Jesus. Talk to us about how you diagnose Parkinson's.
It still remains a clinical diagnosis, which means that we track patients with their story. We see how they perform on their clinical evaluations. And sometimes it's clear when we see certain signs and symptoms of Parkinson's. Other times it takes a couple of evaluations and time to get to that diagnosis.
Certainly, and we know that for Brandon, it did take a little bit of time. So Dr. McInerney, why don't you talk to us about what makes a good candidate for deep brain stimulation?
Sure, well, I think probably the most important thing is that we get the diagnosis right. And so we all work together to try and make sure that we've got that nailed down. And then after that, you know, this is something where we're trying to get the best possible outcome, and that's a patient's decision. And so we really need people that can work with us, that we need them to be part of the team. And that's when we do, I think, our best.
Yeah, and certainly it definitely made a difference in Brandon's life. Now, Dr. DeJesus, you do this for other people, for other different neurological conditions. Tell us about that.
Yeah, currently it's a therapy that's approved for other patients that shake, like essential tremor, dystonia. We also see it in epilepsy and even in obsessive compulsive disorder.
And I know that Brandon gave us a good explanation of what DBS is and how it's done, but why don't you walk us through the process, Dr. McInerney?
Sure. Well, it is brain surgery. So we have a lot of technology to try and be as accurate and precise as we can, but our goal is to get these wires that are about the size of a piece of spaghetti, basically, into very, very specific targets within the brain that we measure in millimeters in the operating room, map out to a thousandth of a millimeter. And once we get those in position, we can secure them and attach them to a little device. It's a battery and a computer to run them and do the stimulation. And that's what we program as time goes by. And so that's, you know, that's what we need to do in the operating room to get it done. And it's a lot more work than that, but I think that pretty much sums it up.
Well, it's amazing though what you do and the outcome, what happens. I mean, you could see there in Brandon's life, you could see it with Jam, with her just putting the glasses on before and after. Really, truly amazing. Talk to us more about the outcomes.
Sure. Well, and I think, you know, our bottom line is, our goal is we want people to be better. I think we all go to medical school because we like to make people better, and we know we can. And it's just so exciting for us to see that. Everybody's better is probably going to be a little bit different. But I think the vast majority of patients are like Brandon and Jen, that they really feel like they can do things that they weren't able to do before. And that's just so gratifying for us to be able to be a part of that.
Yeah, it certainly is wonderful. Now, Dr. DeJesus, we saw that Brandon, he loves giving back, and he's continuing to do that. He's helping you with some programs. Talk to us about that.
Yes, I find that our patients are our best advocates out there in educating and being resources for others. Brandon has been working with us for the past year, teaching other medical providers and learners that are going to be providers, such as physician assistants and other medical individuals that are in medical school.
Yeah, and he is a wonderful example, that is for sure. Dr. McInerney, we always talk about the future. We're always looking into the future. What do you think the future holds for this technology?
Well, the future is very exciting. And, you know, we already on these devices are able to actually listen to people's brain signals and identify the signals that are causing problems and try and get rid of them with the stimulation. What I think the future is going to hold really pretty soon is going to be that these devices are actually automated, that they can do that. Once we set them up, they can do that on their own and, you know, kind of respond when people are more symptomatic or less symptomatic. And that's going to be, I think, even more game-changing in terms of the amount of benefit that we'll be able to see for our patients.
Yeah, and I think that's what Brandon said, a game changer. And it certainly is a game changer. Thank you, Dr. DeJesus, for being with us. And Dr. McInerney, we will be talking with you a little bit later in the show.
Great, thank you.
Thank you.
And if you would like more information, or if you would like to make an appointment with the Penn State Health Neurosurgery Team, call 717-531-3828 or visit online at pennstatehealth.org.